What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another video. It's currently 5 o'clock in the morning, and in this video I'm going to be bringing you through what I eat in a day. And pretty much I have rice and lentils here that I prepared them last night in the instant pot, and now I just need to turn it on and cook it. So it's only going to take 20 minutes. So I have that with a few herbs and spices, and I have sprouts and broccoli in it with stock cubes. So I have white rice in it, and I'd usually use brown, but I had none left, so I'll stick that on now and crack my back. Yeah, so see. So here's everything I'm gonna put in my shake. So I have a So I have my lunch, and well, breakfast and lunch, which is lentils and rice, avocado, sauerkraut, and then there's cilantro or coriander. And yes, I am starving, so I'm gonna have this now. Then I'm gonna make some pasta and a shake for lunch. So see you then. So I'm gonna show you what I had for breakfast yesterday, and that was 100 grams of green lentils with 100 grams of rice, 100 grams of broccoli, sprouts, tablespoon of nutritional yeast, and then I had an apple after. So I'm gonna break down my meals that I had yesterday. So that came to around 880 calories. Then, as you can see here, so I'm on Chronometer right now. If you haven't heard of this app before, it's more for like breaking down certain nutrients, whereas like you could also use my fitness pal, but it's not as in-depth as this. But from this meal alone, I've gotten 27 grams of fiber. That's 72% of my daily recommended amount. Then, as you can see, 110% iron, 14% calcium, 50% vitamin A, 167% vitamin C, and so on. Like, this is, it's a pretty decent meal. Like, I'm hitting B2, vitamin C, vitamin K, and yeah, just smashing the iron, no saturated fat, very little anyway, and there was about 40 grams of protein in that meal, so that's in and around what you want to be getting. So I ate four meals yesterday, I think it came to about 135 grams of protein, so yeah, it's looking good for meal number one.
So this is pesto. I just mixed the hot water with it, so I could get all of it out a lot easier.
I end up having the same meal as well for the last meal of the day, so I'm just gonna double that up for when I add them all up at the end, so that's just a reminder. On the last meal of the day, I had red lentil fusilli with pesto that I made myself. So this isn't really a very nutritious meal, but the nutritional yeast adds a bit of nutrition to it, and there is some iron, I think, because it's made from red lentils, so they're quite high in iron, and there's about 24 grams of protein in that. So that was meal four, and then meal three was the same as meal one, which was the lentils and rice. So I'm gonna show you all of the nutrition added up at once.
We almost forgot to dissolve the stock cube. Don't want that happening again. Done it yesterday and took a spoonful of my food and got some stock cube in my mouth, and it was just there, like, didn't know what to do, like, just had to bleed and like swallow the thing. So yeah, it wasn't a nice experience, but didn't know that time, so it's all that matters, really. As long as I learn from. So I'm gonna make a shake now, which is gonna consist of mixed frozen berries. There's 300 grams there. Then I have a multivitamin,
I'm gonna show this all on Chronometer so you'll be able to see exactly what's in what. So I have some kefir cultures that I've been growing repeatedly in this bottle, and that's coconut milk I'm using. Then I have some mint kale, that's 100 grams, then I have 25 grams of sunflower seeds, pumpkin seeds, there's the multivitamin, there's about 5 grams of creatine, about a tablespoon of nutritional yeast, a bit of black pepper, ginger, turmeric, some maca powder, and then I'm gonna have 10 of these chlorella tablets as well, so just to help clear up my skin. So I'm gonna make that now. So there's my next three meals. I have my shake, my lentils, rice, sauerkraut, avocado, then I have three pieces of fruit, and then I have pesto pasta. So I'll definitely throw all this stuff up on Chronometer and you'll be able to see the nutritional breakdown. And yeah, I'm just gonna eat an apple now myself, and it's 6:30, so I'm gonna go to the gym. I'm gonna do a pull workout, so back and biceps. Yeah, that's gonna be fun. So long enough day ahead of us, so gonna enjoy this level. Look, how are you doing? You well? Looking well, bro. Keep it up. Good stuff. Good stuff.
I'm gonna give him the car and see if he eats it. Wow. Impressive book.
So I'm just out there finishing a workout there, and it is 9:09, and I'm just gonna have this smoothie. So yes, gonna do that now. Enjoy. So I am currently walking 1 mile around the park with Mick, and we're speed walking. We're trying to get around the park. My partner got around in 12 minutes, and yeah, it just looks very funny, like, so proper. Haven't sped walked before, but this is gonna be the third person. We're gonna overlap, but anyway, do you wanna be in the vlog, bro?
You got head, you know what?
You can say hello to your future self.
Alright.
Yeah, so. Yeah, man, just look back on it and just be like, here's me. So the reason I'm doing this right now is just to overtake Sam, really. How many reasons? Sadly my watch is dead though, so can't actually track what my heart rate is. We're sort of just doing it by measuring it by putting our fingers on our what's that vein called? Your jugular? On your neck? Yeah, and then just multiply by 10, is it? Yeah, so just thought this would be an interesting event to get on camera, and yeah, so I had a new pesto pasta earlier. Didn't record it because I was at the top of the U and there was a lot of people there, and I didn't know how to like act normal with a camera around a lot of people. But anyway. Yeah, so check back in when I have my lentils and rice. See you soon. Excuse the fringe. Here's my friend Kesh.
Hello.
Kesh. And then here's my friend Mick.
Are you still going with this vlog, babe?
Yeah. So and here's my other friend Sam. You may have seen a few of them before in some of the videos, but as I finish that walk now, and yes, it's sunny in here. But anyway. Trying to eat me with that food in a bit. See you then. So in total, I've hit 96% of my targets, which is pretty good because I wasn't trying like
that hard. I sort of know from experience what has what in it. And that came to 3,358 calories. Then we can see here that I had 270% fiber, iron 300%. No problem getting that in. Calcium, if I was having oats and more milk, I'd be able to hit that no butter, just because of my sort of limited diet at the moment, trying to heal my psoriasis. But you know, this explains why I'm full of energy all the time. So vitamin A 300%. I'll move the arrow over these so you'll be able to see what foods are high in each of these vitamins, so you can just pause the video at any time if you'd like to look in more depth at them. So have fun and enjoy. And I just have a multivitamin mainly for the B12, vitamin D, and iodine. I don't have any sea vegetables at the moment to get iodine from, or iodized salt, but yeah, I have 137 grams of protein, which is more than enough to build muscle. And yeah, I've no flaxseed left at the moment, but I would have smashed the fats if I had I had that. And I have chia seeds down there as well, but can't really eat them at the moment. But you'll be able to look at what foods has what nutrients if I can scroll up the page. Usually I aim for like 100 grams of greens each meal. I just had a few extra bits of sprouts and broccoli yesterday, so I'm recording this on the 5th, which is the day after I recorded the stuff I recorded yesterday, just because I was quite busy. Forgive me. Sodium, I had like 2 stock cubes yesterday, which I did in fact dissolve into the water, so I didn't actually get them in my mouth and have to just fucking eat them. Like, sorry for cursing. 137 grams of protein. If I was eating more variety of foods currently, I'd be hitting cysteine, leucine, methionine, no butter. So yeah, if you want to see where you're at hitting all these targets, you can download an app. You can also use the web browser, but I'm pretty happy with all that. So yeah, I think that's everything. So
it's currently 4:30. I got in about an hour ago and I'm going to be doing some stretching around 5:00. So yeah, I hope you were able to take something away from this video and have a better insight of where to get certain nutrients from. Like, the bulk of my calories at the moment are coming from lentils, rice, lentil fusilli, and pretty much the stuff you're seeing in this video is what I've been eating the last, I'm not sure how many weeks, but I usually do eat a serious more amount of variety. What? Doesn't even make sense. I usually eat way a bigger variety of foods than I am in this video, but just trying to clear up my psoriasis. It's probably about 90% gone now, which is good. So when it's 100% gone, I'll hopefully do a video on that. And yeah, I'll be eating way more foods, doing more stuff on nutrition and meal prep, I'd say, is something. Like, I usually make my food every day just because I feel like if you meal prep certain foods, they're just not as nice then. But obviously, like, if you don't have the time to be making your food every day, it would be best to meal prep it. So I'm gonna start doing things more like that in the future. So hopefully you took something away from this video. If you did, let me know down below, and thank you for watching. So I'll see you in the next one. Much love, peace, I'm out.